Welcome to the second part of Herping Phetchaburi. It's not all about herps though. Here's a lovely tarantula for you. We've been seeing a lot of these. If you watch the first part, you will know that we finished with a glimpse of a green cat snake, and we will see more cat snakes later on in this part as well. But in the meantime, here is an enormous green stick insect.
This thing is huge. That's just incredible. Absolutely incredible. Size of it compared to my hand.
I promise more snakes. And here is a female white-lipped pit viper. Note the absence of a white stripe on the body, showing that it's a female. But also look at the size of the body. She's obviously eaten a meal recently. Here's a juvenile white-lipped pit viper in classic ambush mode. And by way of variation, here's an oriental whipsnake. This is a diurnal species, and you can often see these resting up in bushes and low trees during the night. And now have a look at this beauty. My goodness me. A common wolf snake. This is the species that I most often kept as a child living in Singapore. Quite a decent size one, this one. Not too concerned about us. Obviously it knows we're here, but moving nice and slowly so we can get a good look at it.
That's the dropping right there, right? The frog's dropping?
Yeah.
Right in the center of the frame. That's where the that's a fresh frog poo right there. Maybe that was the last snake it ate. So what we think just happened, we were filming that plumbeous water snake up on the top of this rock here. We tried to move out, but and it was very strange. We thought it was going to come out the front of the rock because it was afraid of our lights. But then it got dragged back down under the rock, and when we looked down under for it, this is what we found. Absolutely extraordinary. And the snake is somewhere inside. Presumably still alive.
Yeah, that's right.
Now I am absolutely hopping mad. I have screwed up here big time. I thought I was filming. There was a plumbeous water snake on a rock and I pressed the record button, only I didn't. And I've missed an amazing piece of footage. I think the culprit here is a blithe river frog, very large species of frog, obviously large enough to eat snakes. Extraordinary. Well, it's the right shape, but it's not a snake. This is almost certainly an Asian swamp eel. And here again, a checkered keelback resting up on a bush over water, as we've seen before. And in this case, we will see why as I move away.
Hang on.
I got.
And as I promised, another look at a green cat snake.
It's really struggling with something there, some aspect of, okay, now I've got a bit of, yep, that's a good size, isn't it? How long would you say that is? You're still going
two?
Through the tail there.
Just shy of two?
It's not two, but it's no. Especially quite heavily built. It's not super
sure
long.
Sure that's not two? That's a big snake.
Yeah.
That might be two.
I'd say about one.
I guess it
one
could have been if it
60,
didn't have
maybe.
Lost a tail, yeah. Maybe. But.
Yeah, okay, off it goes. Fantastic. We get some lighting up there. Might still be able to see it. Oh, no, it's turned back that way.
As if that wasn't enough, almost immediately we found another younger and slightly more colourful green cat snake. What an absolute beauty this is.
That way, lovely, beautiful green cat snake. So we've kind of lost count, actually. We know we've seen 8 different species and we've probably seen about in total 20 or more snakes.
Well, that was the end of this trip in Phetchaburi province. Tomorrow we'll be going into Kaeng Krachan National Park. And if I get something interesting from there, I'll be posting that shortly.